You are listening to an Arrays of Living Summer Reflections podcast episode. It is summertime, and over the next few months, you will get an abundance of vitamin D. You will be able to be outdoors even more so than in winter. And this is the time to sit back, take in all that nature has to offer in abundance. The decision to be the greatest you is a decision that once taken cannot be undone. Even if you tried, a restlessness will root inside you and grow. That restlessness is your inward flow and spirit, obstinately admonishing you because it knows the disservice to yourself and the world. You were born for a purpose. You took a body to have a human experience for a purpose. The disservice to yourself and the world is when you don't pursue that service, when you don't do what you were meant to do. This world that would be stripped of your light may include your spouse, your children, your friends, other family members, and many closest to you. They are there to be your teachers. They are there to guide you. They're there to give you certain experiences that will take you down the path to your purpose. And I know you keep hearing it over and over again, purpose, 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 purpose. Put whatever word makes you feel better. Your potential, your ability in this book to fly and see the possibilities of you. Call it whatever you wish. It could also include someone who needed a lifeline of hope, a nudge of support, or just a glimpse of what is possible within all of us. And you might be the instrument to help them see that. That is one of your possibilities.
Jenn Drakes always tells us not to underestimate our possibilities. Always thrive to achieve what you want. Never give up. And now, with another episode.
Me, all of us have an obligation by our mere existence as humans to strive for greatness. Not at the expense of others, however, but greatness that will serve and uplift others. In reading this book, I do not know how you will envision yourself or what goals you will pursue. But I hope you will be inspired to strive for something more for yourself. At the very least, may it help you gain the fortitude to rework unconscious behavior that are deeply rooted in routines that have dominated your life and dominated in a way that doesn't best necessarily serve you. If it's dominated in a way that serves you, that elevates you, that gets you to spring out of your bed every morning because you are doing and being the best that you can be and you are embracing the change of you every day, then fabulous, awesome, amazing. Yes, you are living life to the fullest. But if they're not serving you, then may those routines be reworked to such an extent that life becomes more bearable and meaningful. The something more can be one Aladdin carpet or many Aladdin carpets because it's leveraging all the gifts you were given. It's leveraging all the things of perfection that you were born with. We are vibing in our summer reflections episode, having a great time recapping, reflecting, and just enjoying the summer beats as we continue. We will be continuing. Stay tuned. Stay with us. Hit the like, hit the subscribe, and pass the sharing on to friends and family to listen in. We are vibing. Summer Reflections. Every achievement is something to be acclaimed and be thankful for. Thank those who helped with their contributions and think about your readiness to reciprocate something back, no matter how small. This does not have to be done in a visible way. Reciprocity is not about tooting your own horn. It is about giving your time, your attention, sharing your knowledge, or giving something to someone who truly needs it. You don't even have to know they need it, but they do. And that's as simple as giving a smile to someone in a day, saying hello to someone in a day, and just giving that extra little bit of attention that someone needs, whether you know it or not. It is about reciprocating in a way that is authentic to you. Whatever you choose to do, be sure to do it with a good heart and a good mind. Never do anything that carries insincerity. It eventually catches up with you and creates hurricane-level conditions for your carpet. And who needs that? Not the most pleasant weather to fly in or navigate through, and can ground you until the storm passes. If your vision remains out of reach, it is expected that you continue following all the prior steps to keep advancing to that vision. On the flip side, the question becomes, what happens when you have attained the vision you had formed for yourself? What then? In reaching your envisioned endpoint, you can either remain status quo or you can assess how to go beyond what you imagined for yourself. The irony, and this is not in the book, the irony is that the vision may never ever look like you had formed. So that's where you just keep going.
Something that was taught by Jenn Drakes is to always write down your achievements. Read them whenever you're feeling down. And now, with one more episode with Jenn Drakes.
As we spin into action, the things you need to remember is that you have reached a cruising altitude and you are flying. This is you reaping the rewards of following your action plan. Don't give up before you get to the reaping of the rewards. Many do, don't. This is you using your rocket fuel to rise to your first level. It is you actively working on your overall fitness. And it's you seeing, recognizing, evaluating, and seizing opportunities. That means you're getting more congruent with your mind-body connection. This is you maximizing your genie power to take on new heights. And you must keep moving forward. You must choose to be goal-oriented. You must choose to endure through any challenges and obstacles you face. You must choose to break through any glass ceilings encountered. Choose to seek help when needed. Don't let pride stand in the way. Go with humility and grace. Choose to persevere and not give up. Choose to recognize and celebrate your achievements. Always stop and celebrate your achievements, no matter how small or how large. And choose to grow and learn. Choose to see the opportunities and blessings as they appear. They're always there around us. We just have to raise our frequency. We just have to work on ourselves sufficiently to be able to see them. Choose to explore those opportunities as they unfold. Do your due diligence. Choose to work on all dimensions of your fitness for overall well-being, and choose to remain in control of yourself. You are always in control of your state. Choose to pick yourself up and start again after any setbacks. Don't stop to cry over it or to beat yourself up. Just get up. It's just like riding a bike. When you first start to learn and you fell, your parents will say, get up and go again. Keep going at it. Keep going at it. And next thing, you're an avid bike rider. So do the same. Pick yourself up and start again after any setbacks.
You have been listening to a Summer Reflections episode, and this is our bridge from one season to the other, with season 4 coming up with deeper conversations, more guests, and just exploring all the sparkle and the vibrations of each and every one of us as we continue our You discussions in season 4. Stay tuned, stick with us, and enjoy your summer months listening to their summer reflections episodes. A Rays of Living thanks you.